Mahogany Homes. The only requirement is not to be homeless, so make sure you have a home before starting this minigame. So let's get straight into the items you're going to need, and what your inventory is going to look like. You'll need a hammer and a saw, a couple of steel bars, plank sack from the Mahogany Homes later on, and the type of plank you're going to be using for your contracts. Starting off, regulars are used for beginner contracts with no level requirement. Oaks are used for the novice contracts at level 20. Teaks are going to be used for the adept contracts at level 50. And finally, at level 70, you'll be able to do expert contracts and use mahogany planks. Everyone is going to want these items. However, everyone doesn't bring the same teleports. You're going to be traveling constantly in this minigame across four cities. Varrock, Falador, Ardy, and Hosidius. Don't worry about run energy, as you'll restore your run by drinking tea as given to you in this minigame. You can wear graceful or fashionscape it up. But there are two main options for teleports. To achieve the fastest possible experience in Mahogany Homes, you must stay on Lunar Magics and use the NPC contact spell to contact Amy. When on Lunars, you have to use the teleport tablets instead of runes for transportation. You don't need to use Lunars, however. Regular teleport runes do just fine, and Rune Pouch can help you save inventory with both of these methods. For Iron Man accounts, making the tablets could be more time than it's worth doing. A couple of teleport tips before we move on. Moving your house to Hosidius gives you a quicker teleport to the southern contract that's located there through Xerix Talisman Will. And if you're using house tablets for Hosidius, you can place them in the bottom of your inventory for an easy right-click teleport. It's not required, but it's worth mentioning that the Ring of Wealth Falador Park teleport is the closest teleport to where you can begin a contract, and is also closer to the Falador contracts than the normal teleport. And here are two ideas for your inventory setup, the left being Lunars and the right being the normal spellbook. There are a lot of variations to do this that work just as well, so do what works best for you. Onto the game itself, Mahogany Homes is very straightforward, and instead of building furniture in your home, you are training by working throughout these four cities. There's a carpenter master in each city that can give you a contract. Falador is the easiest for you to teleport to, and NPC contact allows you to begin a contract wherever you are. Whenever you pick up a contract, you will get instructions telling you straight where to go. Some tips: when you pick up your contract, notice which option your contract choice is. For example, if I do teak contracts, my choice is the third option, so I'm going to press the number 3 on my keyboard. The reason this matters is that you notice when you build the teaks in the homes, you can just continue pressing 3 because that will be the third option for every build. And this number option will match for all types of contracts, so keep that in mind if you want to be lazy like me and spam the same key. The furniture you repair are easy to spot in the homes, but if you're missing something, you can easily talk to the owner and they'll tell you which furniture you're missing. You're going to have to bank quite a bit, but banking as you go is a great option. When you do any of the Falador contracts, you're going to run by the East Falador Bank. And there's also a contract north in the Hosidius that runs directly by a bank. It's worth stocking up your inventory even when it's not completely empty. You're going to use 9 to 17 planks per contract, so there's quite a bit of variation between bank times. And this is especially true after unlocking the plank sack. Having a bank teleport like a dual ring isn't a bad option when you find yourself out of supplies, but banking as you go covers a lot of it. So with steel bars, most contracts require you to pair something with one steel bar. But if you find yourself in a situation with planks, but no steel bars in your inventory, Noella in the Ardy Market, and both Northern Varrock contracts never require steel bars that can be completed without them. Alright, so here's a very exciting graph on why you want to do Mahogany Homes. So here I have a comparison of other popular training methods for construction. I want to dumb this down as much as possible. An easy way to think of Mahogany Homes is you are going to spend 2 to 3 times less money training construction depending on the other method you would have used. But it's going to take you about 5 times longer than it normally would to train. Now you'll notice I don't have the rates for regular or oak planks on here. I don't think regular planks are ever worth using in Mahogany Homes, and if you have to use oak planks, it's going to be about 85,000 experience an hour. The rates you can get from Mahogany Homes will vary depending on how focused you are, if you're using NPC contact, and if you're using all the teleports. You can expect an average of 200,000 maybe with mahogany planks, and maybe 130,000 with teaks, but these can go much higher. Some more numbers for you, and this is especially important for Iron Man accounts. One plank will go much further for you in terms of experience in Mahogany Homes. The amount of money and time not used in gathering planks is great for rushing construction. So essentially, 1,000 teak planks used in Mahogany Homes would be about equal to about using 2,800 teak planks normally, or 2,000 if you're using mythical capes. And for every 1,000 mahogany planks you use in Mahogany Homes, you can expect to use about 2,400 normally. So it's easy to see where this is beneficial. So after doing a contract, you receive points for completing it. 2 for beginner, 3 for novice, 4 for adept, 5 for expert. The first thing you're going to get from the reward shop is the plank stack. It stores more planks, and it's just amazing for the minigame, so you're going to want this first. After that, it's completely up to you. There's an equipable saw that can save you one inventory that costs 500 points. The carpenter outfit costs 2,000 points for the full set, and will give you a very small experience bonus when training construction. You can buy blueprints for your home for 2,000 points. And last, there are the supply crates. Right now in the video, as you can see, I'm opening 100 supply crates, so you can have an idea of what you'll get. It averages out to about 10,000 gold per crate. That's it for the guide. I hope it helped. If it did, you could help me back by giving me a like. Subscribe if you feel so inclined, my dude.